Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we will talk about molecular geometry. Again, I am not an expert in the field of chemistry, but I will try to explain everything as simple and as easy to understand as possible based on how I understand it as a student. I highly recommend that before you continue watching, be sure to watch my video about Lewis dot structure first, because it is difficult to determine the molecular geometry without knowing the Lewis dot structure of the compound. Molecular geometry is basically the three-dimensional arrangement of atoms in a molecule. Related to it is the VSEPR theory, or the valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. In simpler words, electron domains will repel each other, which will make an arrangement that places all electron domains as far away as each other. What are electron domains? These are bonds or lone pairs that are connected to the central atom. For example, in ammonia, we have 3 bonds and 1 lone pair connected to the central atom, so we see that we have 4 electron domains. To make things clear and organized, I have a chart that summarizes all the possible molecular geometries for compounds that has until 4 electron domains. We will tackle each of those later in this video. Molecules with only 2 electron domains will always be linear. A good example is carbon dioxide. Carbon has no lone pair, but it has 2 bonds with the oxygen atoms. The formation that will put the 2 electron domains farthest from each other will be on the opposite sides, so we can say that it is linear. Molecules with 3 electron domains can form trigonal planar or bent. Let's start with trigonal planar. It will happen when the 3 electron domains are all bonds and there is no lone pair. A good example is sulfur trioxide with this Lewis dot structure. Sulfur has no lone pair, but it has 3 oxygen atoms bonded to it. Here we have the sulfur as the central atom, then we add the 3 oxygen atoms and it should look like this. When the electron domains are 2 bonds and 1 lone pair, the molecule will be bent. A good example is sulfur dioxide with this Lewis dot structure. Sulfur has 1 lone pair and 2 oxygen atoms bonded to it. Here we have the sulfur as the central atom, then we add the 2 oxygen atoms, but they will be pushed down by the lone pair, which should look like this. Molecules with 4 electron domains can form tetrahedral, trigonal pyramidal, or bent. Let's start with tetrahedral. It will happen if all 4 electron domains are bonds. Methane is a good example with this Lewis dot structure. Methane has no lone pairs, but it has 4 bonds with hydrogen. Here is our central atom, carbon. We put the 4 hydrogen atoms in it, then they will all spread out. To further visualize this, the molecular geometry looks like this. When the electron domains are 3 bonds and 1 lone pair, the molecule should be trigonal pyramidal, like in the case of phosphorus trichloride, with this Lewis dot structure. Phosphorus has 1 lone pair and 3 bonds with chlorine. Here's our central atom, phosphorus, with 3 atoms of chlorine. Adding the lone pair will push the 3 down. To further visualize this, the molecular geometry looks like this, which resembles a pyramid with the 3 bonded atoms facing down. Lastly, when you have 2 bonds and 2 lone pairs, the molecule should be bent, like in the case of water or H2O, with this Lewis dot structure. Oxygen has 2 bonds with hydrogen and 2 lone pairs as well. Here we have our central atom, oxygen, then put the 2 hydrogen atoms. Adding the 2 lone pairs will push the 2 bonded atoms down. To further visualize this, the molecular geometry looks like this. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. Leave your questions or suggestions in the comment section below. Like and subscribe for more videos. Thank you!